Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shweta. So welcome to activity 12 and 15. I hope you have counted your blessing in the morning itself. Now you have more than 120 blessings. Then secondly, today we are going to practice 12th and 15th chapter together because both are related to relationship. It's ideally said that your life is been influenced by 5 or 7 close people related to you. So imagine that you are driving a boat and with your families, then you have 3 fishes attached to your boat who are helping you to take your boat in the forward direction, and there are 2 stones attached to your boat. They are very heavy. So what do you think? Your boat will move or it won't move, or it will move in a slow pace, etc., etc. Look, there are many possibilities, but today we are dealing with the relationship. For example, we take 5 people you are influenced by, and those 5 people are your closed one. So who are these 5 people? They say some people are those who have magical people who had made a difference in your life, that is in a positive direction. So we can take them as wishes. And 2 people you say are like the stones. They are the person whom you do not like. In fact, you might be hating somebody. You might not be talking to them, or if you are talking to them, you are not talking in a good fashion to them, or you suppose are not talking and you are not even reacting to what their life is going like. They don't exist for you. So these are the stones of your life. So today's task is, first sit down and write, are you influenced by 5 people or are you influenced by 7 people? Look, it is psychologically proven that your behavior, your reaction, your goal setting, your energy is working over you depends on these people around you. Look, if you are attached to 5 people, say for example, then first write down the 3 most influencing persons of your life. If you have done the exercise first, we have tried of gratitude game, that is similar to this. So in that exercise you have written about 1 person. Here we are talking about 3 person. So take out time of suppose 1 hour in your day today, and write down about this 3 person. Take one by one. First you take the person's name and then write 10 things you are grateful about him. Say for example, I am grateful to Amit because he has changed my life. He understands me. He helps me. Similarly, you can write about people you are most influenced by, and then write the things, or you can write the time spent with them or what they have caused changes in your life. Anything you can write about them. After completing this, you are going to call them, or you are going to sit in front of them, say them, don't talk in between, and you reread those things to them and see how do you feel about it. Then if talking about those 2 people which you hate are acting like stones in your life, so suppose you are not talking to them, you are hating them, in fact you have not talked to them in last many years, say, then write the name of those 2 persons and write things you feel grateful about them. Say for example, before the relationship got spoiled, you must have spent a good time with them. So write about that time spent with them. Or if you say never, the relation was never good, so write about the good qualities of that person. I know every one of us has some or the other good qualities. So write about those good qualities of that particular person. Then what you have to do is, if you are in contact with that person, or if you can get his number by any way, just call him and say that I am sorry, please forgive me and thank you for everything, and just leave the thing like that only. You'll say that I have not done anything wrong. He is wrong. Why should I say sorry for it? If you understand the Ho'oponopono technique, what we have practiced earlier, or if you understand law of attraction, or if you understand the karmic correlation, is the thing that whatever you have done is coming back to you. So if that person is doing wrong to you somewhere or the other, you are the reason for he doing wrong to you. And more importantly, leave everything what I'm talking about now. you have to move towards your goal. You'll say law of attraction is not working in my life, magic is not happening in my life, I'm not experiencing anything like that. So I'd like to share a story with you of my personal experience. I was not talking to my uncle for more than 2 years just because he had an argument with my father, and I was present over there 2 years. I was not even talking to his wife. I just used to talk to their son and daughters. So it was like she was sitting with that uncle during that argument, so I decided not to talk to them. So finally, when I came across this thing, I met Neeta Arora. She is a very good friend of mine and a teacher and a guide. She explained me that if you do not complete this bond of hatred, solve this bond of hatred or leave these stones out of your life so that you can propel towards your goal. So I was like, okay, let's get a try. And coincidentally, on that day itself, my auntie visited my clinic to just take the medicines of my grandmother. So I was like, what can I do to make her understand that I am sorry? So she was like about to leave, then I came near her.